Hi and welcome to Cheekyricho Cookings. Little sausage spirals cooked in the pie maker. The ingredients are very simple and they are in the recipe box below. So let's get started. I have got two slices of just white bread here. I'm going to soak that up with a half a cup of milk. Just let that absorb all of that milk and it'll go quite soggy. It'll save you breaking it up. To which we are going to add some freshly chopped parsley. Some just sliced spring onions. There's just one whole spring onion there. And we're just gonna mix this up and let it absorb all of that milk until it's really quite soggy. We're sprinkling in some freshly cracked pepper there. I'm not adding any salt because the sausage mince that I'm going to be using already has quite a significant amount of salt in it. And we're gonna be serving it with either a tomato sauce, a barbecued sauce, or a spicy tomato relish. And I've showed you how to cook that in a different video. Now this is our sausage mince here. This is nearly done what I needed to do. I've got a couple of slices of prepared puff pastry here. It's just been thawed, that's all I've done with that. And we're going to add our sausage mince now. Sometimes you have trouble getting sausage mince, and if you do, just get some sausages and squeeze the mince out of it. So just squeeze it out and mix it all up. The bread will absorb any fat in the sausages. It will keep it nice and moist, and it'll make it go a little bit further too, especially if you've got a little bit of stale bread you want to use up. And you can also freeze that for later use as well. Okay, just squeeze that out, or you don't get it all over you. Discard that. And we're gonna just mix this all together. Instead of making sausage rolls, which aren't going to work very well in the pie maker, these are going to go into a little spiral. And I've shown you lots of different spiral puff pastry recipes in the past. You can put this into a piping bag if you want to, and it probably would be much easier to do that, but not everybody has access to piping bags. And so I'm just going to fashion this with a couple of spoons along our puff pastry, which we are actually going to cut into half because we've only got a small pie maker. If you want to make a great big pie and cook it in the oven like this, of course you can do that. Put it on some baking paper, cook it at 180 degrees for about 15 minutes until it's nice and puffed, golden, and cooked all the way through. This is quite a wet mix. Turn our pie maker on now. No need to grease this because puff pastry's got quite a bit of fat in it and it is not going to stick. Just turn that on, get a couple of our sheets, just cut them in half, put our meat along the edge of that, because we're gonna roll it right up. Just enough to make a little thin sausage. You don't want it too thick because it has to roll around, you see. You can put sage in this, you can put mixed herbs in this, you can put any amount of different vegetables in it if you like. Carrots come to mind quite readily. Now just fold this up, peel back our paper. And this is about the same size I would make for mini sausage rolls. Just close it back on itself. And now, this other one as well. Make it quite firm, peel our paper back. And roll it over. This recipe actually came as a recipe suggestion from one of our viewers. So thank you very much for that, Clara. So a wealth of information about cooking our Clara is. So we're just gonna go around like so. You should get two pie maker pies out of each one of these. So just cut that through. And that is ready to go into our pie maker. That's all you have to do. And do the same with the next one. See, I've managed to keep my hands quite clean for this operation. Cut it in half. Just like so. Make them smaller if you like. That way you'll have a lot less mince in your little roll and a lot more pastry. But if you're more of a meat lover than a pastry lover, make them nice and solid. Okay, pie maker's on at the moment, so we're just gonna drop these guys in there while we prepare the rest. Push them in like so. Close the lid, they'll rise and cook in about 10 minutes. And on to our next one. These are great for kids' parties, and if you're doing a bit of entertaining over the holiday season coming up, or the school holidays, kids can help you with this. Not the actual cooking, but the preparing of them, and they'll love them. Put some grated chopped up mushrooms, or some grated zucchini, mashed pumpkin, spinach, basil, anything you like, really. Okay. Fold it over, and you can freeze these ahead of time and just thaw them, wrap them individually in this plastic wrap or any non-stick wrapping, and you can take them out and cook them when you're ready, but you have to thaw them first. Don't get too excited if they burst out a little bit because they're all going to be folded in on top of each other, so there won't be any problems. Okay, now cheap as chips and quite tasty. and they don't take very long. They look quite interesting, and you can take them to school events and whatnot. Okay, pretty simple, entertaining, something a little bit different. It's not likely that these are going to be at the next party you go to, unless of course you go to a party with a couple of our viewers, because I'll be dying to try this little invention out. And it's quick, they're sort of self-sealing, no need to baste them or anything like that. By the time they get wound up and stuck into the pie maker, they won't be able to really go anywhere. Okay, you could experiment if you want the double pastry on the outside just so that it doesn't split. Well, this is a chubby. I don't know if I want to get that in there actually. I'm gonna squeeze him in. Get it right to the edges. Fudge a little if you have to. Alright, take this off. Okay, around we go. And we'll see what's happening in here, shall we? Pretty good. Now just a word of advice, don't make them too small, too thin, because they won't rise up and get sort of squashed together. But these are really more sausage rolls than sausage rolls. I'm actually gonna turn them over. You could use phyllo pastry too if you wanted to, and just close the lid and cook the other side. Okay, after about 15 minutes or so, depending on the power of your particular pie oven, this is what you should have. They're really crispy, they're quite round, and we're just going to fetch them out and serve them with some tomato and some barbecue sauce. Okay, we just fetch them out after about 15 to 20 minutes and they're nice and round. They're actually more rolls than a sausage roll. Serving them with some tomato and some barbecue sauce. Pop the next batch in, close the lid down and actually squash it down and wait for them to cook. You don't need to keep these in an oven or anything. The internal heat there will continue to cook the pastry that's wound around in the middle, and it'll be absolutely gorgeous. Crisp, tasty, interesting texture all the way through, and serve it with your favorite sauce. And there you have a Cheekyricho Cooking's sausage pinwheels cooked in the pie maker. Very economical, great little party treat, and I'll show you what they look like inside. Just grab one of these guys here, it's not too hot. And there you have it. Top that with a little bit of our sauce. Give this a try. Crispy, savory, easy to eat. And I don't know why, but the puff pastry that's in the middle is actually cooked right through. Must be the heat of the fat in the sausage mincer, does it? But not much fat came out of these, so it's really quite lean. But it's a great treat for after school, after footy, cold Saturday afternoon with a bowl of nice tomato soup or something. And they taste great. Thanks for watching.